Hi guys, welcome to AppSense Pro. Welcome to another video. So in this video, I'm going to show you guys how you can add circle menu, which will look like Instagram style status icon menu on your Shopify store, which will look like this. So if you're seeing my screen, that's how it's going to look like on the desktop version. And if I switch to the mobile version, that's how it's going to look. And it has a lot of customization option as well. So if you want to have a menu like this on your Shopify store, make sure to watch the complete video. This video is for everyone. So if you are a merchant and you don't know how to code, then this video is for you, because in this video, you don't need to learn any code. All of this customization features will be added through your theme customize, and you can add this section on any of your theme. No matter you are using a paid theme or free theme, you can use that on any of your theme. So make sure to keep watching this tutorial. And don't forget to subscribe the channel. Subscribing this channel will help us create more valuable content for you guys. So make sure to subscribe the channel. Without further ado, let's get into the screen. So guys, that's the section which will be added. And if you're seeing this channel for the first time, I keep creating this type of videos where you guys can improve Shopify UI and improve theme of your Shopify store by adding different sections. So there's another example of this video which works in auto loop, and it has this option to add title, option to add these buttons and the color overlay. And again, all of this is without any coding knowledge. You will be given a code for customize section, which you can customize through your theme customize settings. And here I have this collection slider. Recently I created this pie chart. You can see all of the videos in this channel. Just make sure to subscribe this channel. And this lookbook section, which I personally like the most. Take a look at that. So it's just one image, and you can pinpoint and change the marker position from your customized settings without any coding knowledge. And you can do this really easily. And one more thing I would like to tell you guys, if you guys are looking to improve the sales of your store, try out our new app, which we created just for you guys, which is called Big Bulk Discount. And it is basically for volume discount or tired based discount. So you can motivate your customer to add more product to the cart. Super simple app. All you have to do is just define the quantity and select which specific collection or which specific product you want to implement this on. And if client add this product to the cart, they'll be seeing like if they add two product, they're gonna get 10% automatically added to the discount. So you can simply motivate them, add more product to the cart. Make sure to check out link in the description, or you can simply search for BBD discount Shopify. Cool. Let's get into the tutorial. So that's the art section, which we'll be adding in this tutorial video. And first, let me show you what are the settings you'll be getting. So that's the customized settings, and that's the circle menu. So all you will have to do is just click on art section, find the circle menu and add it. And you can add more circle or bubble item here. So if I click on add bubble item, you can see that it's adding more item. And all you have to do is just click on any of the bubble item, select the appropriate image. Click on done. You can see that it's showing up the image here, and you can simply link it to any of your collection, any of your page, or any of your product. It's that simple, right? And the further customized settings which you'll be getting is by clicking on this circle menu here. So when you click here, you can see that it's giving you the width to adjust for desktop. So you can adjust it, and you will also be getting a sliding effect with that. So if I click on save, the remaining bubble item is going to show on sliding mode. So that's how it's going to work. And here we have this adjustment for mobile. We can adjust it on mobile as well. Icon size, we can increase and decrease the icon size. Let's try increasing that to 150px to see how it looks. And here's how it looks. And we have this sliding effect. Cool, right? And we can also, again, adjust the width of the section. And that's for the mobile. So if I switch to the mobile version, you can see that we have a different settings for mobile where we can increase and decrease the sizing of the icons. It's a completely mobile friendly section, and you don't have to add in any customizations separately for mobile. It's completely optimized for mobile. All you have to do is just set it up here, the icon size you want, the gap, so the space between icon and border you can see. So let's try increasing that to see how it looks. It's gonna be for the desktop version. So here you can see now we have this gap showing up, which we added here. And again, this one is for the mobile version. So let's try increasing that in the mobile version. Now you can see that we have this wide gap between the icon and the border, right? And here we have the icon border thickness. We have increased it to 10 pixel, but let's make it to 0 and 0 for the sizing and for the desktop version as well, because I don't like it. Perfect. Here we have the option of adjusting the text size, which is showing up here. We can also use the custom font by enabling this. So initially it will inherit the fonts from the theme settings, but if you want the custom fonts, you can simply enable this toggle and have this showing up, the custom fonts. And let's increase the size to show how it looks. This one is for the desktop version, so I'm gonna switch to the desktop version. Cool. The font size has been adjusted. Let's try switch it back. Okay, you can see it works fine. And similarly for the mobile, and here we have the image border color, and this one is for the gradient. So let's hit save first. And I'm wondering why the gradient is not showing up. It should show up completely fine. Maybe it's due to the custom font thing. Nope. Let's see why the gradient isn't showing up. So I'm gonna remove this gradient here and add a new gradient. That's weird. Okay, I think we removed the border thickness. That's why it's not showing up. Yep. Here we go. You can see that the gradient and the border is showing up now. If we remove the gradient, we can also show the single border color as well. So if I just remove this gradient here, it's gonna show the black border, which we have selected here. And here is the option for text color. And here we can change the section background color. So if I move it to this, you can see that it's being changed, and we can also add the gradient to the section background color. Here we have margin, and here we have padding. And if we scroll down, we can hide this on mobile or hide this on desktop version. So if you want to have two separate sections, different one for the mobile and different one for the desktop, you can do that as well. Now let's move on to installing this section on your theme, and let me get back to my store backend. And we're gonna go to Shopify dashboard and then go to our theme section. Okay, so here's our Shopify dashboard, and I am going to click on online store. And here I have done a lot of customization already, so I'm gonna take a new theme. Let's take this time Sense theme, because this is supposed to work completely fine on all of the themes. I usually create tutorials for Dawn theme, as it's the most used theme. And whenever I test something on Dawn theme, it means that it's going to work completely fine on all of the free themes, because all of these free themes, Dawn, Spotlight, Craft, Refresh, Sense, all of these have a same code base. So it's just a difference of styling and customization. Other than that, the backend code is completely the same. Okay, now let's add in the Sense theme. And our Sense theme is being stored. Guys, while this theme is being stored, Shopify is running a promotion where you can have your store for just $1 a month for starting 3 months. So if you are a new merchant and you want a 3 months of room and space to get in some more sales and then start the Shopify subscription, then this is your chance. There's a link in the description. If you sign up through that, you will get your store for just $1 a month. So make sure to check out that link. Okay, guys, our Sense theme has been installed and I'm going to publish that theme. So click on publish and then click on publish again. Perfect, our Sense theme has been published. Let's review that theme. I'm gonna click on preview and let's close these older tabs. And here's how our Sense theme looks like. Now we are going to add the circle menu. And in order to add the circle menu, let's go back and then click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. And here we are going to scroll down to our section folder and then click on add a new section. And here I am going to name the new section circle menu. You can name it whatever you want. Circle menu.liquid. Click on done. And now let's remove all of the code which is already in the file and then go to the blog post where we have all of the code. And this link will be in the description, so don't worry about that. All you have to do is just click on the link in the YouTube video description, click on this copy code button, and then paste the code here. Once the code is pasted, click on save. And now I'm going to go to the customize. So click on these three small dots and then click on customize theme. And here I am going to add the circle menu on the header part. You can add it based on your page template as well. So if you want to add this on a one single page, you would be adding that within the template section. But if you want to add this globally on all of the pages, you can add this on header, or if you want to display that on the footer, based on your theme and based on your own preferences. I'm going to add this on the header part. So let's click on add section. And here we have this circle menu showing up. And now you can see that our section is showing up and we can simply adjust everything from here as we did before. So let's increase the slider gap a bit. And here you can see we have increased a slider gap. Now I'm gonna add the image on bubble items here. So click on every single bubble item and add the images. Here's the option to link it and first collection. Let's add in a different image for the second collection. Okay, guys, so you can also add the GIF images, which is going to look really awesome. So you can see that we have this GIF image and this animation is looking really awesome. And you can try that on your own. So creating the GIF animations and then adding them here, it's going to look really cool. And now let's check that in the mobile version. And there you go. That's how it looks in the mobile version and the desktop version. And I have already shown you guys how to customize this section further. So make sure to check that out. Let me know in the comments below if you like this section and let me know in the comments below what more you would like to learn. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Until next video, have a great day.